How does Vivekananda compare it to Hanuman that you mentioned earlier in your lecture?
You see, what is Hanuman's special? What is the speciality of Hanuman? Why do children, why do everybody, why do we fall in love with Hanuman? You see, with Hanuman comes this idea of Shakti, power, Bala. He's a personification of power, powerhouse. And all of us somehow are attracted to the idea that we need to express this power that we possess. We know we possess this infinite power, and somehow it kind of got blocked up. We want to open up the criteria which allows this thing to flow through. We all want to tap into power, infinite power. So Hanuman stands for that, Bala. The second thing Hanuman stands for is Buddhi. This ability to, in order for us to really express this Bala, the way you invoke Bala or strengthen, you don't know how we invoke, if you forget, the Hindus are very bad at this. The way you invoke strength is through use of rationality. Don't underestimate the power of rationality. With Vivekananda, it becomes very visible. He says, what I tell you makes sense to you, then accept it. If I tell you something that does not make sense to you, reject it immediately. Another unique feature of Vivekananda is this. Most prophets will say, look, come and sit near me, come near me, sit at my feet, and I'll protect you and I'll look after you. Just leave it to me. Come and sit at my feet and worship me. Now with Vivekananda, you see, there's no picture of Vivekananda here. Do you know why? If I start worshipping a picture of Vivekananda here and start tinkling bells in front of him, I tell you, he will come out of the picture and smack me. He will say, look, Mister, you missed the point, don't you understand? I don't want you to bow down to me. Look at it, these are his words. Don't bow down to me. For how many generations, for how many lifetimes have you been bowing down to prophets and sages and seers and breaking your backbone? Stop being a creepy crawly. Stand up on your own feet and find your own destination. Find your own spiritual destination. You assert yourself. Look at the language. In fact, I shudder to say it. He says, don't bow down to Vivekananda. And I shudder with the next sentence. He says, become better than a Vivekananda. Better. Look at the power of the modern prophet. He's not worried that you might surpass him. He wants you to surpass him. He said, come on, grow up. This is the power of strength. This is why Bala, Buddhi, unique feature. And the third one, the youth kind of shudder, is Brahmacharya. And many modern proponents interpret Brahmacharya means, you know, live a life where you control your senses. This is a give. This is, if you like, a compromise statement. It says no lovey-dovey, bluntly, no lovey-dovey, because it gets in your way of spiritual progress. These three things are very powerful. And the reason why I link Vivekananda with Hanuman is this. Look at these two characters, Hanuman and Vivekananda. Both of them lovey-dovey, no-go area. No lovey-dovey. The only difference between Vivekananda and Hanuman is this. One is with a tail, one is without a tail. The only difference between the two. Look at their lives. They lived for their masters. They gave their whole life for their masters. And they were the messenger of strength. They were both teaching us how to become real men and real women. Assert ourselves as spiritual beings. Do not be creepy crawlies. You've done enough of that. How many more lifetimes will you spend like that? Grow up. Become. Assert yourself. Assert your true dignity as a spiritual being. Powerful stuff.